Hey guys, RichKitch20 here, and today I'm going to bring you something a little unorthodox and kind of weird. Today I'm going to bring you some clicker hero stuff, but it's going to be an interesting version of that. First things first, I want to mention is that I'm going to have my own music really, really quiet in the background, not like Shuggy to where it's really loud in the background. Just really quiet because their music you cannot change the audio to, and it's very all just like intense and shit once it starts looping again. That's supposed to be longer than that. There we go. It gets annoying pretty fast, and I won't have their sound effects because also loud and also kind of gets annoying. So I'm gonna have my own music in the background. So this the purpose of this playthrough is not to show you from the beginning to end kind of thing, because I was gonna show you beginnings level content, but then I went back and hard reset my game and kept the import file just in case I wanted to bring it back. And it takes for fucking ever in the beginning. I forgot that because I've been playing this game for like a month or two. So I forgot how fucking slow it is in the beginning. So I'm not going to do that shit. Instead, this is going to be for those people who are trying to get up to the higher level stuff and who aren't using hacks and stuff, because you can hack this game and add in all the stuff you want and shit like that. But this is a this is how to show you how to get through the game after you've ascended to get to higher level stuff. And I'll go through all this extra stuff in the beginning, because as you can see, I definitely have ancients and relics and shit like that allow me to start a fully ascended game at wave 21. So we're gonna oh I guess we're gonna go up here. So first things first, since I start with 100 million gold, also because of ancients and shit, I can already get this big boy down here. But I'm gonna start up top, and this will also help people out a little bit for people that are starting new and fresh as well. The first things you want to do is you want to keep leveling people up until you can't level people up anymore. I'm going to start out by popping two into her for some fucking reason. I'm going to pop one into him so the money can keep coming in while I'm showing this. And then you just want to keep leveling stuff up. I'm not going to get the one thing. I already have 14 billion and 1 billion DPS. Oh, my screen's lagging up. I'm killing things so fast. Anyways, right here is the abilities. Of course, if you're ascending, you already knows what these are. If you're not, pretty much every, almost every hero, not every hero, every hero every now and then has an ability that you can unlock. The cooldown should be 10 minutes on this. I have it down to 2 minutes and 30 seconds. Once again, ancients and shit. And it lasts for a minute and 30 seconds instead of like a minute or like 30. I think it only lasts for 30 seconds initially. So yeah. You know, good stuff. So, like I said, first thing you want to do is get people up as high as possible. What I like to do when I ascend, and I'm going to have this go on farm mode, so it's just going to keep doing its own thing and keep going up. It's doing a lot off of just one person. I like to just pop one into each one and let it do its own thing for a little bit. Each one of these people don't initially look like this, but I also have all my heroes, except for the new ones they just recently released, gilded. So, yeah. They do a lot more damage than they would originally. For example, Tree Beast doesn't do 15 billion damage a second at level 1. That's because I have a shit ton of hero souls. And because of he's gilded to fuck, and with ancients and stuff, my increased gilded damage and, you know, all that shit we'll get into later. Usually he does like 5 damage per second when you first get him, so that's why, you know, I can do shit like this. So pretty much I just keep letting them get money. Once you get to the point where you can afford one person, the next person will unlock. If you didn't know, you haven't gone through this game yet. And so I'm just going to keep hiring people down the line as I get more money. Then at one point, I guess around here, since, I mean, I'll get to 164Q. Okay, pretty fast. Yeah, once I get there, then I'm going to go back up here. While that's doing its shit, I'm going to get everybody's abilities. It's not going to mean shit because they're still not going to do any damage. compared to the people I've just got, but it's not a big deal. I just like to flesh out all their abilities and shit. So I like to, if you hold down control, they now added like Q, which is fucking crazy. Q levels them up by like 1,000, but I guess I could do that right now. I just don't know what that's max is all about. Anyways, I like to just pop them up to 200. Well, it's technically 201 because I put 1 point in. And then just get all their abilities. And then just keep going down the line like that. Just get all the abilities. We just got the second ability, Power Surge, 100% increased DPS. I don't like using that at the moment, even though I could keep refreshing it because of my ancients, since I'm idle, meaning I haven't clicked on an enemy in a minute. I get, I don't want to get this wrong here. I get 11,000% increased damage when I have not clicked on anybody. So I'm doing 11,000% more damage now because I haven't clicked on anybody. So I'm not going to, I'm not going to activate Power Surge because otherwise that would take me out of idle and I do 11,000% less damage at the moment, which I don't need. So let's just keep leveling everybody up. Get them all up to 200. This will not go this fast, you're like first time leveling up, but if you can see, I have 1,266,000 hero souls, which is not a whole lot, in all honesty, compared to some people in my guild. they probably have like a couple billion hero souls, if not more. That's why they get all the way up to wave like 10,000, but I mean, I could go look up how to hack and get up there like they did, but I want to get up there myself. I want to actually do it myself and not just do it the cheap way. So there you go. Let's see, let's just keep leveling on that. I think, yeah, my highest wave is 3,418, which I probably could get up higher than that, but it gets really slowed down. I just prefer ascending to get more hero souls and whatnot. They're getting all the way up to wave like 11,000 or some shit. It's fucking crazy. Anyways, back down here. Like I mentioned, just keep leveling these guys up. We will get to the Ascend guy soon, and I'll tell you which one you do not want to level up. But, I mean, when you click on it to try to level it up, it'll be like, are you sure you want to do this shit? And you can say no. And you realize, oh shit, I clicked the wrong ability. So here's the third ability right there on Alexa. Critical Strikes. This thing is godlike. I wish it had as low of cooldown as these ones, because then I could keep crit strikes going the whole time. I could get to wave like whatever the fuck I want, because crit strikes are fucking overpowered, but we'll talk about that later. I won't say they're overpowered because it's nothing I'm going against, but they're fucking, it's good, it's so useful. So keep leveling. As you can see, even with all the abilities up at level 2, at level 200, they still do 0% of my total DPS. So yeah, which is actually starting to slow down now because I'm taking longer than I usually would. Oh, and also you won't have 500 seconds, well, 530 seconds to kill a boss, but once again, ancients and shit. So I get, it's almost impossible not to kill a boss in this time unless they really take no damage from you. So there you go. But yeah, you won't have that. You only have 30 seconds to kill a boss when you're first starting out. For a while after you're first starting out. Here's another ability, Metal Detector. It's pretty good for gold drop, but once again, it will decrease your idle gold gain and damage per second. So, I mean, yeah, I don't really use these abilities anymore, unless I really need to. King Midas is one of the greatest guys to get because of his massive gold increase from all this shit, and also increased critical chance by 3%. It's beautiful. So he's really nice to get early on. For those of you who don't know, progression mode or farm mode, wherever you think, farm mode is when you have it off. Progression mode is when you, it will, once it kills all the people, which normally you'd have to kill 10 people to move on to the next, but once again, ancients. So once you kill these, it'll automatically go over to the next map instead of having to click it every single time. I think you get that once you've ascended once, then you can use progression mode, which is really helpful when you're doing shit like this. So I'm starting to get some damage. He's got 1% of my total DPS now, so I'm starting to get a little bit more damage. Usually this would never slow down because I'd already be way in front of this, but there you go. This is the Dark Ritual, which I'm going to explain a little bit here because it kind of confused me. This will multiply your current DPS by 5% is times 1.05, which is 5%, for the duration of your world, which means every time you use this bad boy, you get 5% increased DPS until you reascend. So you always want to keep popping this. Since, once again, Ancients, this usually has an 8-hour cooldown. I have it down to a 2-hour cooldown, and when I use my reload ability, which only has a 15-minute cooldown, I can use this every single hour. So every hour I can increase my total DPS by 5%, which is pretty good. So you want to keep popping that every chance you get. For now, I'm not going to worry about it because it really is not going to help me at this point, since I'm going to be mass leveling up my DPS here in a second. And I'm going to let you know where the... Oh, yeah, see, there it is. I almost did myself. Emin, I don't know how to pronounce this guy's name, but this guy right here, he's the one you ascend on now. The Ascension comes over here. So when we get to him, we can ascend at any time we want. Don't do that right away. I'll tell you the point we usually want to ascend, but for now, don't bother doing that. Just keep leveling up, everybody. Now we're starting to do some good damage again, because we're actually getting up to the top line people. As you can see, they are melting over here now. Once again, they're just dying super fast. This guy right here, the Dread Knight, is the point in the game where you are going to slow down immensely your first couple times through the game. Like, almost like your first time through the game, you won't even be able to get to him unless you try using your abilities to get as far as you can and just let the game farm while it's off for like months. Will you be able to get to him? It's the point in the game where everything just jumps exponentially, and it's super hard to get to the next person to level up every single time. But we'll get that. We'll get more into that once we get there. Continue to super level everybody. We got our next two abilities here. Beast Lord had the super clicks, and Aphrodite has the energize. Super clicks increase 200% your click damage, which is fucking awesome. Mixed with when you energize this bad boy Clickstorm, it makes it do 20 clicks a second, and you increase that by 200% with 50% increased chance to crit. Yeah. Say goodnight to all your enemies. They will be dead. Alright, so let's finish these guys off. I think Shinatobe, or whatever her name is, or his name, I think it's her, increases, it does the whole reload. So example, I don't want to de-idle myself. I guess I will to show you the difference. As you can see, I just lost like 100,000 damage per second there. 100,000 in. See, that's 2-hour cooldown. Now every hour I can pop that. And as you can see, this slowed down greatly. I'm going to have to wait a minute before it goes back up, but that's all right. Because I'm doing this for educational purposes, I guess. Alright, we're already back up there, because Grant over here is an animal. Alright, so as you can see, I can already hire the Dreadlord, but I'm not going to do that yet. I'm going to wait, get Frostleaf up here. So when you get to this point, you're going to try to level up Frostleaf to 125, because I believe that's when you, or at least, yeah, 100, because you can get all DPS increased by 25%. You're going to try to get him up to get all his abilities. You probably won't be able to get him up to level 200, because that's going to be really fucking hard. That's when you're going to max out the top people, and you're not going to be able to purchase Dreadlord. I'm just special right now and can, because of these all Ascensions and Hero Souls and Gilded Damage, but we'll get into that in a second. So at this point, what you want to do is you want to go back. Usually you'll be leveling these guys up as you go to try to get their increased damage, because if you don't know, once you get to level 200, every 25 levels after, well, at 200 and every 25 after, you're increasing the damage that your old guys do by times 4 every single time they get to 25 levels, because they don't increase their damage that much per level, maybe like 8 trillion, which compared to D, which isn't even a, I mean, that's a made up number, because I don't think there's a digajillion or some shit. So yeah, they don't get you damage, so it keeps going by times 4. Once they get to 1,000, it increases by times 10 every 1,000. so it'll go back to times 4 after that. But then at this point, you want to try to get everybody to at least 1,000. So that will be no problem for us. And he went up to 9% damage per second. So he's actually doing some useful damage. Now we can get him up higher than that because, you know, we get on that. But usually, well, at this point, you just want to try to get everyone up to 1,000 so they can actually do some meaningful damage. I like to go back and do this myself because, as you see, they're just going insane on damage now. And so at this point, we're just going to go back. There's a lot of people, so this is going to take a little bit. Yeah, you just want to keep going back, raising everyone's damage. And try not to blow all the money you have. If try to get to the point where it's red, where you can't get any higher, but without blowing all the money you've saved up to. So like, this is 3,000 out of 12,000. Not that big of a hit. You can take an upload. My game is lagging a little bit because I'm recording and things are dying every second and trying to level people up at the same time. So it's lagging a tad bit because I'm clicking and then like a split second later it will actually level up. It's supposed to be instant, but that's alright. See, I'm not going to level that one up because that will drain all the money I currently have, and we do not want that. Because then it's going to try to have to level that all up again, and you can't get other people as high up as you'd like. So just keep leveling up all your lesserlings as high as you can get them. I guess I call them lesserlings. They're always playing catch up, because as soon as you hire the next highest person, which is going to be insane levels of damage, they go from like, oh, we're now doing like 30% DPS, we're actually helping you, to we're doing zero again. We're sorry. You know, they will always be playing catch-up. No matter what way you look at it, they always play catch-up. But when you're stuck and you can't level anything up, they can actually really help boost, or you can't get the next person, they really help boost your damage overall. So you, while they're not that important when you're getting new people, eventually they will become the only way that you can get damage. When you're waiting to get someone like Dread Knight, or once you get Dread Knight, the person after Dread Knight and all that shit, you know. It's what you get left with. And there's going to come a time where you have to do this again. I don't know what that max button does. I mean, I don't fucking know. The reason I'm not leveling up Cid is because you don't need to. Like, I usually get her to 1,000, or like 2,000 or 1,000? I don't remember. And I just leave her there because, or I think it's a her. It looks like a her. It looks very much like a her, but her name's Cid. And I've only seen guys called Cid, so I don't know. But because her damage will not increase exponentially, you'll get no times 4 on her. She can't be gilded. So, once you get her up to 200, you get all her abilities, you don't need her, because you get people like this guy, increase your click damage by 0.5% of your total DPS, and there's a bunch of people who have that, so it's like maybe like 5 or 10% of your DPS is sent into click damage. That's all the click damage you need. You don't need to level her up. It won't even scratch this number on the top. So do not worry about that. You don't have to level her up after you get all her abilities if you don't want to. If you're bored and just feel like, why the fuck not, sure, go ahead. But you don't need to. Trust me, you do not need to. She is useless at that point. And I guess I can get him up higher than I usually could because I spent time talking about that. Alright. Let's just keep increasing. I wasn't paying attention to that one. That could have been really bad. But I guess it wasn't, so we're good. We're almost at the dollar bill, which, and they had so many high level for damage that they just had to make up random shit to count for the damage, and then they get to scientific notation at some point, because that just makes it easier, but it also makes it more confusing, so I'll have to deal with that here, here in a little bit. Kind of soon, but not exactly soon, so we got some time before then. These guys won't be able, some of these guys up here won't be able to get to 1,000, but getting them up to several hundred, is good enough. I mean, that will get them high enough damage to actually be on the charts. So there you go. And all these people are actually doing, more damage than it looks like they're doing, because it'd be like, wait, 35 of the dollars when it's at 5,000. the dollar sign, is not 70% DPS. They actually do it way more than it says that they do because of the whole gilded damage thing. And I know I used a lot of the dollar, but I don't want it to get very high in the dollar because it's going to go through Atlas. But that's out of my control at this point. Unless, well, even if I stop it, that's out of my control at this point. But that's okay. We're almost done leveling these people up as high as they can go. Yeah, and I barely got her to 1,000. You're not going to be able to get... I doubt you're going to get Grant to 1,000. No, but close to. But he's at least doing some damage. Get Frostleaf up here. Yeah, let's knock that down big. Yeah, and see, he's not at 1,000. He didn't get that times 10 damage. But he's still doing 72% of DPS, so there you go. And then, once you get all of them up... which will take days, by the way, if you haven't even ascended once. Even if you have ascended once, it'll take a long time, like hours to days. So don't expect to get to Dread Knight anytime soon. But that's the steps you take. Then you can get him and try to get higher. Get him as much as you can. Since I'm, you know, really high up, I can get him up to 200. And then get all his damage increases. Usually it's 100% to 150%. That's what everyone's is if you didn't read them. Some people have the increase all DPS hero by 25%. This girl down here, Betty, does that for everybody when you first get her. Very nice, very helpful. She's a very helpful person, though, because of that, her damage always suffers. She's like always has the least amount of damage almost over any hero. So now we've gotten to the point where we can get Atlas, and this is... Like, once you get Dread Knight, getting to that dollar, that will take for fucking ever. Once again, but Dread Knight really does help to get you to, like, wave 200, 300 around that area. He can help you get around there, but then, you know, it becomes a struggle once again. But now we can get Atlas. Pretty much, once you get Dread Knight and all his abilities, then it's going back, increasing people up as much as you physically can, all the way down the line, etc., etc. But we can pop him up to get most of his abilities here. And then we just gotta wait for the cash to flow. See, we need that there. I don't think he has a 120, or he or she, I don't know what Atlas is technically. I don't think he has a 125 ability. He does not. So pretty much at this point, we're waiting for scientific notation. And while we're waiting for scientific notation, which I believe... I don't think it's next. It might be next. I think the asterisk comes and then it's scientific notation. But I'm not 100% about that. So we're already just insta 1 second killing everything at wave 500. That is not going to happen. I'm sorry to tell you, that is not going to happen. It's gonna be slow rolling. So while we're waiting to get the scientific notation, I'm first going to explain scientific notation, and then if we have time after that, which usually there's not a whole lot of it, I will explain all the other stuff that I need to talk about. So scientific notation. Oh my god! Once you get to scientific notation, which is, if you don't know what that is this thing over here, like 4.7 E to the 69th power. That's all scientific notation shit. That's when a number becomes so fucking big that the only way to be able to calculate that number without going into fake-ass numbers like ampersand up on the top there, is to turn it into scientific notation. Like, that's why that was invented, I think. I mean, I know the exact reason why it was invented, but I assume it was because they were getting to numbers so fucking high, they're like, fuck this, let's make it easy. But yeah, so once you get there, the only way I can describe the effects that has is that every number past the E is such a exponentially higher increase than the one before it, that it creates this weird effect in this game. And I'll explain that more when we get there, because for the time being, that's all you need to know. So, gilded. How you get gilded, what gilded even means. When you, when you get gilded, which means you beat a certain boss above, I think, level like level 200 and above on these world waves up here in the top. That's where we're at 600 now. Once you get to 200, I think every five to ten, because every 5 to 10 waves is a boss. At every wave 5 and 10, you know, 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, every 5 waves there's a boss. And I don't know if it's every other 5 or if it's every 5 you'll get a random gilded hero. It could be anyone, it could be the same person again and again, but it will give one of these people randomly a gilded hero. Well, I've gotten to 3,400, so obviously I got a lot of gilded shit. But originally what that means, when it'll give it to one person, and that will increase their DPS by 50% per each gilded that they have. Obviously you can do the math, mine's way higher than that, we'll get into that, but that will help increase that their damage, and that will make them look different than they originally would. Except for, of course, I don't have it on these new guys because they just came out and I haven't gotten past 3,400 since they came out. And I don't understand what goes on with I don't know his name, but he has this like weird effect thing that I haven't been able to figure out, but it's not important. It's not, yeah. Anyways, the reason that they have more damage per gilded is because of the ancients, but we'll talk about the ancients here in a second. We are at the asterisk, as I believe that's an asterisk, so we're about to get into scientific notation. But we'll deal with that later. Here's achievements. They did something pretty unique with achievements. I hate that they added so many more achievements to go with mercenaries and shit, but whatever. Because I almost had like I was like 75%, I almost had 100% achievements, but now I'm back down again because they added all these games achievements. But pretty much it increases your overall damage per second whenever you satisfy one of these achievements, which is cool. Well, if for the lower level ones, it's like it starts at 1%, but eventually it maxes at 5% per achievement. So when you go through these achievements, you get increased DPS. For some of these achievements, like one I even still haven't gotten because I think it's physically fucking impossible. For these ones, like click 12 times per second, you just activate click storm and then click while click storm is activated, because it will count your clicks with the 10 clicks per second from that. That's how you get that one. And that one 14 times per second. How you get 25 times per second, you energize your clicks per second, so it does 20 clicks per second, and then you madly click while that's happening, you'll get 25 clicks per second. It's really fucking easy. I still haven't figured out how to get 35 clicks per second, even with the abilities. I've gotten 26 clicks per second, that's as far as I've gotten. I think the only way to get that is to hack. I mean, I think it's broken anyways. Half 5 mercenary in the end. Everything else is, there's no tricks to any of the other ones, you just, you do them. And you get them. I mean, they're just, you know, they're straightforward. I've almost gotten this one. Sweetie Swooty coming for that treasure hunter booty chest. I don't know. I've almost gotten 10,000 treasure chests, which is hard to do at first until you get ancients. But we'll talk about ancients here in a second. This is stats, of course. These, you know, just tell you about all the shit you do. They're not really important. So these are ancients. All these bad boys here, these are ancients. How you get ancients, I think you have to ascend once, I believe. You pretty much just have to get hero souls. Which you see right here on the top, I have hero soul. When you get a hero soul, which you get from killing these bosses, like when I killed this guy, I'm going to get 304 hero souls added to my ascend thing here, which means like I don't get those hero souls, but the next time I ascend the world, which means start the world over, it's like new game plus for those of you who don't know, then I get to then I get those hero souls once I ascend, and they get added to my hero souls. Every hero soul gives you 10% increased damage from like all sources, I believe. Just, yeah, all damage increased to all sources. And since I have 1,266,000 hero souls, that's over like 12,000,000% increased damage or some shit like that. Some crazy shit like that. Maybe not. Yeah, 12. Maybe 12%. I don't know. It's at least over 10,000,000% increased damage. Yeah, it's 12,686,380% increased damage. So that's why I do a lot of fucking damage and can get to this point really fucking easily. That's why. Just in case you were wondering, I think I can get the next guy. I can at least level Atlas. ching, ching. And there we go. Let that just keep going fresh while I'm explaining all this. So yeah, that's what Hero Souls does. And then you, to buy Hero Souls, which I only have this one, which I don't really need, I'll probably buy here eventually. You go into this and it'll bring up like 4 random ancients. And every, like, the first ancient you get, I think, will cost you like 1 Hero Soul. The next one will cost you 2, then 4. It doubles every single time. So eventually, when you get to the last one here, it's 150,000 Hero Souls just to buy one, which means you're going to lose 150,000% damage. Or wait, no more than that, because each one is 10%. So yeah, you're going to lose a fuck ton of damage just to get one. So you have to really use them sparingly, you know. But eventually, you'll get so high to the point where you can just get them all. Which takes a long time, by the way. Don't expect to get all instantly. And then you can level them up. They each have different effects. Like this one right here, 120% to gilded damage bonus per guild. So that means instead of getting 50%, I get 1,250% per guild, per time they get gilded. So that's why you see them over here with only like 20 times 28 guild, but with like 35,000%, you know? That's why. The ancients. They're awesome. This one right here is really important to try to get to. If you're guild and shit, I can buy my next one. Yeah, scientific guild here, bitches. Because it gives 9,000 damage to critical clicks. That is devastating. And these ones don't have a maximum level, as you can see here in the little scroll thing. So you can just keep getting stronger and stronger. This one right here is why I can fight bosses for so fucking long. 500 seconds to boss fights. That's nice. It's not necessary when you're getting heroes, and it's really expensive to level up per click, but or when you're getting ancients, but it's nice to have eventually, because then it's like almost impossible to lose to a boss. 8,000% click damage. That's nice if you're actually going to click, but whatever. This one here that I have scrolled down, I'll plus him out. I don't level this guy up past 20, because it's like plus 20 to starting zone after Ascension. I don't mind running through the Ascensions, because as you can see, or through the zones with Ascensions, because as you can see, it goes by really fucking fast. I'm already at 700, so I don't care for wasting souls on this guy. So I just put him to 20, minimized him, don't have to worry about it. This guy can actually get really good, but you have to level him up a lot to get there. That's a lot of Hero Souls to get him there. But 2.1% DPS increase per click combo. So it means every single time I click, it's going to increase the DPS by 2%. So when you activate, and that activates with Clickstorm. So, yeah. That can get up to a really high point, but it starts at like 0.1% increase, so you have to spend a fuck ton of souls to get into there. I'm going to keep getting up to the point where clicking is actually going to be insanely beneficial for me, because it takes a long time for that to go away. So when this click storm has only a 60 second cooldown, you can keep maxing them out a lot. This one is also very important. This is like the first one I got. 9,540% increased gold gain from monsters when you don't click for 60 seconds. That is good at getting money. A lot of money. Also mixed with this one, 3,000% increased gold drop. Very nice. 2,500% gold from treasure chests. So when this treasure chest over here dies, I get a fuck ton of money compared to what I would. This guy here is also pretty important, because he only requires 1 Hero Soul to level up no matter what. That's why I have him at level 2,200, no maximum level. He does 11% increased damage added to Hero Souls per level up. So I get that, you know, like 12 million damage from Hero Souls, and then I get another 24,000% damage from this guy. So not added on, it's added on to after the 12 million percent increase. So it's not like per, it doesn't add on to your souls and make them do like 24,000% damage increase each. No, it's just added on to the end of that number. 6,000 gold from golden clicks, that's not bad. Percentage increase from golden clicks, that's not bad. This guy over here is insanely important that I showed before. 11,000% increase DPS when idle. You gotta find this guy. Keep re-rolling till you find this guy if you're lucky enough. you need him, because he's really fucking strong. 4,000% increased Primal Hero Souls. Very nice. Primal Hero Souls, if you don't know, is only important if you're in a guild. For example, like I am, you go to the raid, and there be these immortals that you and your team has to try to kill. I don't do that whole lot of immortal damage at the moment. But I'm working on it. Primal Hero Souls goes to your immortal damage. That's how you get your immortal damage up. You fight them and you kill them. If you kill them, you get a bunch of Hero Souls for killing them. So that's what Primal Hero Souls does. Let me get back here. And these ones are... This is another one that I don't increase, because it adds treasure chest life when you activate your golden clicks, which the purpose of doing that is getting a lot of money per click for that. But I don't do that, because if your golden clicks deactivates in the middle of a treasure chest life, then it will take, you have to sit there for like an hour before that treasure chest will finally eventually die from your damage per second. So, you know, while I get the point and it's really good for like building up money, I can deal with that. All these ones I minimize, because they're the ones that can be maxed out, and I maxed them out, but they're really good. 25% chance of Primal Boss is really important. 60 seconds to Power Surge, which is this bad boy. This is how I can use these for a minute and 30 seconds instead of 30 seconds. Negative 50% boss life, that is really nice, makes bosses a lot weaker. 60 seconds increase to click storm. Negative 50% hero hiring and level up costs, which is really good, because usually what's his face, like the Dread Knight and stuff, I think he costs like he costs 50% more, so it makes it so you can get him easier, which is, you know, really important to do. 1,000% more treasure chests. Treasure chests don't spawn that often. So when you get this person and increase their spawn rate by 1,000%, yeah, that means they spawn more. That means you can get more money. 6 seconds increased to metal detector, which means 100% increased drop chance from, or not drop chance, but 100% gold dropped from monsters you kill. Fortuna, 10% chance to increase to get 10 times more gold from a monster kill. You know that they've dropped 10 times more gold when they drop like blue or white or whatever color you want to call it, gold on the ground instead of yellow or gold, whatever color it is. 60 seconds duration to super clicks. That's this bad boy. And here's the I get 100 million gold when I start after I ascend, so that's why I can just start leveling people up. 60 seconds to golden clicks. Negative 5 monsters required to advance to the next level. That's right below the astral lift button here. It says astral lift level 744, that number below there. Usually it's 10 when you get this guy and max him out. It's only 5, which is nice. You don't have to wait nearly as long. I don't even know if I can kill these guys anymore. My damage is... once again, I have 530 seconds, so it's unlikely that I won't kill them. But my damage is slowed down a lot, if you couldn't tell, because I've been fooling around with all this. 60 seconds to the duration of lucky crit strikes, which is very nice. And then the big one here. Negative 75% skill cooldowns. That's why this went from 8 hours to 2 hours. This went from 10 minutes to 2 minutes and 30 seconds. And that cooldown begins the second you touch it. So that means 1 minute and 30 seconds of that cooldown is spent during the duration of the actual ability. So it only has a 1 minute cooldown. This one has a 6 minute cooldown. Same with these ones. These ones have 15 minute cooldowns, but usually they last 96 seconds. Usually they last for 90 to 120 seconds, so that means it's only like a 13 minute cooldown. And then that one's a 15-minute cooldown. You can't really reduce the one of that, but it's only 15 minutes instead of an hour. So, you know, or like an hour, two-hour cooldown. So, there you go. So that's what the Ancients do. They're very important to get. These are relics. You get them one time per Ascension, so it's important to ascend multiple times. You can read what they do. They're just nice little bonuses and buffs and stuff. Mine are all common level. I did have an epic and blue one, but they were like level 5 and shit, so there you go. You get Forge Cores to upgrade them. Forge Cores you use by salvaging the relics that you don't want or don't need. So there you go. Here's guild stuff. You can look at message boards and shit like that. Here is what is this tab? I don't remember. They're mercenaries. That's what they're called. They're your mercenaries. I have 5 of them right now. I don't really want any more. I don't know if you can get any more. I don't remember. Because they die quite often. And you have to spend rubies to bring them back to life. And I don't spend money on it, so it takes a while for me to get them back to life. You can see some of them are pretty high level. Some of them are pretty low level. You can send them out to do quests for you, to get gold, to activate abilities for free, to get hero souls, rubies, relics, all that good shit. They really do help. I don't want ability damage, but they really do help, especially when you send them out to get gold, when you're trying to get a lot of gold early on. They really, really help. So now that we've gone through all of that, let's get back down here. Normally, before you can get to Terra in the scientific notation, you want to go back and try to get these guys up as high as you can, like level 2000. We're not going to worry about fucking around with that right now. Instead, we're just going to level up Terra. Boom. Get that insta-kill DPS once again. As you can see, our damage has gone into scientific notation. So, yeah. This is at the point in the game where usually even I have to wait for a while. Because, once again, it may look to people who only have, like, maybe, like, 200, 300 hero souls. Like, I have a fuck ton of hero souls, but this isn't even that much. Like, I start to slow down at wave, like, 1,400, 1,500. Which, once again, sounds like a lot. When you're at this point in the game, it's not a lot. Because I can get up to about 3,400, 3,500. No problem. This is where it even starts to slow down with me. But here's the point I'm talking about with scientific notation. Like I mentioned, if you have a number, which we'll get there, that is even just 1E. Shit, I can't fuck that one up. I'll do it with him. There's 1E lower than the number above it. It won't take like any money away from your overall totals. What I mean by that is, if you see Dread Knight leveling up right now, once we get to scientific notation. We're gonna level up. Oh, I guess we gotta wait a little bit to get some money to actually kind of make this make sense. Let's see if I can get with Frostleaf here. Come on, Frostleaf. Okay, so right here, like, it's 75 right below 76, and you think, well, that's going to take a pretty big chunk out of 76. You got so much money you didn't even notice it go down. Like, 77. You barely even notice the dip. Because scientific notation goes up at such a high exponential rate that any E that's like 76E instead of 77 barely even dense the 77E. It's ridiculous. But likewise, it makes the monsters harder, because once the monster's life starts getting into scientific notation, if their life just gets to, like, I'm at 75E damage per second, if they were at like 76, even that I'm almost at 76, it would super slow down the rate at which I can kill them. So while money-wise, it means you can level people up easier, it means that once monsters start getting up there, it gets harder and harder and harder at an exponential rate, which if you don't know what the word exponential means, go look it up, to start killing them. So it slows the game down once again. So it's good and it's bad. I'd say mostly good, but it can also be bad. So, I should be at 84 soon. I'm gonna cut till I get there. I'm going to just level shit up, all my other people up. At this point, when I'm at scientific notation, should be able to get them to, like, this is max again. I don't like that max button. Should be able to get them up to, like 3 to 4,000, if not more, maybe around 7,000 to 8,000 level each. Just depends at one point in the game. I don't think they can get to 7,000 to 8,000 now. I think at least 3,000. So yeah, I'll see you here again in a second. Alright, back again. We've got a little over not much again. But we can at least get his damage. As you can see, once you start getting these people that have scientific notation, they start doing like 100% of your damage per second. Even though these people have really high damage, they just knock it out of the fucking park. As you can see, I got the next person up and ready to go. That's still not the part yet for me where it gets hard. It is the one after her where I believe it gets to, I think it's like 5e to the 114th power, some shit like that. That's when it starts to slow down for me. But pretty much, we don't really need to go through to that point. I'm just gonna blow up, as you can see, my damage is getting all crazy and shit. Pretty much all we need to see for the purposes of this video is revisit a point that I made. As you can see, I'm already in wave 1011, and I got 23,000 hero souls for the next time I ascend. That number, usually before I get bored and ascend, when I could get it up to at least, like, if I went all the way up to 3,000 without getting bored, I can easily get that number up to like 150 to like anywhere between 150 to 300,000 hero souls for an ascension. Every time. But usually I get bored around 1,500 and just ascend for like 50,000 hero souls. Mostly because I'm trying to go for the achievement. The achievement's like ascending like 1,000 times or some shit, you know. So I'm working on it, you know. So I'm just getting bits of hero souls and stuff. Pretty much what you want to do, like I've already mentioned, every single time when you come to the next person, like for me right now, is that Did NC girl, whatever her fucking name is. And I can't get her, but I'm pretty close. What you want to do at this point is, of course, go back. I already maxed these guys out, because apparently, like, I think level, where is it? Does it say when you, yeah, as you see in the bottom, where in the green at the bottom, it says hold shift for times 10 upgrade, hold Z for times 25, hold control for 100. They just recently added this Q, or at least I'm paying attention when they did, for 9,999. Well, when I hold Q, it says max. So I think level 9,999 is the maximum level. I don't know. The highest I've ever gotten people is like 8,500. So I've never gotten up to 9,999. So I assume that's the max level. So, you know, if you want to max somebody, yeah. But if you don't have them maxed, or if you don't have the money to make them 9,999, I think that was 3 or 4, I don't know. Then if you just hold Q and push, you know, and click to level them up, it will level them up to the maximum level that they can be. So that actually kind of is helpful, so you don't have to, like, slowly just tap, 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 you know, every single person. You can just max, max. But note, you will lose money at that point. But once again, since they're dropping gold at a level of scientific notation, if you, losing money won't really mean a whole lot, because you'll instantly just swipe over the money that's on the floor, you'll get back up to that level of money. So yeah, you just keep going through, you just keep leveling everybody up to their maximum potential. And it'll keep slowly increasing your damage so that you can keep getting to higher and higher levels of shit. And then, you know, use your abilities. Pretty much if you have those ancients and you have them leveled up to the maximum, yeah, you can get your click damage to increase the DPS by a shit ton. And you can just keep activating them every 60 seconds until this one comes available every minute. And you can just start skyrocketing through places. Yes, do it, please, fuck yeah. And yeah, pretty much you just keep using your abilities whenever available. Note, if you're using golden clicks and you have the ancients, that increases chest life and shit like that, you might want to ignore that ability. I do. Metal detector is not that big of a deal to activate, because it won't really screw you over like golden click scan. But yeah, there you go. That's pretty much the strategy. You just keep scrolling that. And yeah, I mean, that's kind of the shit. I don't know why your name keeps switching to Banana. Like, it does that for some reason. Whenever I get, like, it starts out with that Disney name, but then when I get closer to the 99E, it changes to Banana every time. It's so fucking weird. I don't get that. Anyways, not important. So yeah, pretty much that's all I wanted to show you guys. Pretty much, for those of you who have been struggling, like, how the fuck do I get to higher parts? I can't seem to do anything. I just keep running my face into a brick wall. That's what you gotta do. You have to ascend. This game was designed for you to ascend again and again and again. That's why they have achievements for you ascending hundreds and hundreds of times. Pretty much that's how you do these games. And I hope this has been informative. I hope you've enjoyed this. And I will see you in whatever I decide to do next.